I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Your God.
can do something right now. Come on, say, God, I need you to do it right now. God, I need you to do it right now.
One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Oh, show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yes. Walked among men. Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, that is worse now than then. Oh, there's pushing and shoving, and it's crowding my mind. So, Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus, that's all I'm asking of you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone,
that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace hath brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me
grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now was blind, but now I see.
Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring. My heart is torn in pieces. It's my offering. Take me to the King.
Truth is, I'm tired. Options are few. I'm trying to pray, but where are you? I'm all churched out, hurt and abused. I can't fake what's left to do.
Come on.
Truth is, I'm weak. No strength to fight. no tears to cry. Even if I tried, but still my soul refuses to die. Mm-hmm. One touch will change my life. Take me to the King. I don't have much to bring. My heart's torn in pieces. It's my offering. Lay me at the throne. Leave me there alone to gaze upon your glory and sing to you. Take me to the King. Truth is, it's time to stop playing these games. We need a word for the people's pain. So Lord, speak right now. Let it pour like rain. We're chasing after you. Oh, no rules, no religion. I've made my decision to run to you, the healer that I need. Take me to the King. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering.
Therefore, will I offer
offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yea, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Hear, O Lord, when I cry with my voice, have mercy also upon me and answer me. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth Holloway, better known as Niecy. There are no words that can change the matter, but we do know words that can help the heart. That earth has no sorrow, heaven cannot heal. And these are the times to know that only Jesus can mend broken hearts. There may be somebody else who can do it, but I don't know of anybody else who has the power to dry tears from my eyes when we least expect it. So I recommend Jesus. We praise God for the life, Sister Holloway and Holiday. I'm so sorry. I'm looking at this wrong. And I should know better because I know what it means to mess up a name because they destroy minds all the time. Amen. Sister Holiday. Amen, amen. And so at this time, we're going to ask that Minister Tanisha Williams will come with the prayer of comfort and then the hymn of comfort in that order, following which would be the reading of the word.
The rising of the sun to the setting of the same, your name alone get all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise. And so tonight, we have come to thank you and to ask you to heal this family, that you would send comfort like no other in the days to come, that you would send a healing like no other. For the Bible declares that to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And so we ask that you would send comfort from your mouth, that you would send comfort to their ears on tonight, that you would continue to send healing to them like never.
What you're going to do in this family, I pray in the name of Jesus that you Our scripture readings, reading of the Old Testament, Psalms 23, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He making me to lie down in green pastures, leading me beside the still waters, he restores my soul, he leading me to the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointed my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely, somebody say surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Entire 23rd Psalm, the New Testament scripture from the Gospel according to John, chapter 14, verses 1 through 6, Jesus says it like this: let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house there are many mansions. If it was not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. Thomas said, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Selection from the Rehoboth Cathedral Choir at this time, following which we'll have reflections in this order from Ashlyn Richardson and Jadrick Shorter Jr. in that order.
I call you holy, your name is holy, you are so holy to me. I call you holy, but your name is holy, holy you are, and holy you'll be.
I call you Lord,
your name is holy,
you are. Auntie was always front and center actually best in my situation. A lot of times it was when I did go to school, when I got an award, or just to celebrate my birthday and things I was doing. She was also there at your worst. You know, yeah, circumstances in my situation. One of the biggest ones that was really important to me, even though she showed for me in many ways, is when my father passed and I looked up in the stand and I saw her with my mother, and that meant a lot to me. She was always there to congratulate and support you. But I would like one of the takeaways to be in the lessons that she passed on to us while she lived was how she lived. Normally situations like this, you would usually hear, and we did hear it fairly, that it is unfortunate that family has to come together this way. I do slightly disagree with that. I do see unfortunate tragedies like this. They do bring us closer together. Like, look around. Everybody's in this room. This is full of love. And it showed that you guys greatly appreciated Auntie and the life that she lived while she was here. You guys are also a living example of one of the things that she does. No matter how hard things are, no matter how tough things are, in tough situations, you can always count her to be there. Situations like this also open a door for us to come closer together, to celebrate with each other, which was something Auntie also did. She was there for the good times and the bad times. So, with that being said, I would just like to remind everybody here that all of us are loved by Auntie, and she feels our love. And I'd also like to remind us that, like her, like the life she lived, we are fighters, but more importantly than that, we are lovers as well. And I'm going to end on that, and I'll let Elijah have a couple of words as well.
Excuse me. Hi, everybody. My voice is a little hoarse. I'm going to keep this from the heart. My name is Eli. I'm Denise Young's nephew. I'm also Tommy's son, her brother. When Nunu passed, I was hurt. My father told me that I should go see her the day before she passed because today might be her last. And I didn't go see her. I chose to go to my high school graduation. And she passed, and I regretted that decision. I didn't have enough mental fortitude to speak at her funeral, but that painful experience, along with many others, has prepared me for today. And I tried to be there for my aunt and my cousin KK, her only child, as much as I could. And I wasn't there every day, because everybody just can't bear to see someone you love like that. But I was there in her final moments. I love my aunt. Before she died, I explained to her that I didn't get to know my aunt Bernard as much, her sister, my father's sister, but I also loved her as well. But I am more than grateful that I got to know Denise Holiday. She was a mother, an aunt, a grandmother, a sister, a daughter, a friend, and most importantly, a lover. As I watch and observe how this family prides itself on togetherness, Auntie embodied that, as well as the rest of her siblings. Nunu instilled that in them. For those of you who don't know, that was my grandmother. It's apparent. It didn't matter what we talk about, whether it be how much my father got on my nerves, how much CJ grown, or how much K is her spoiled brat. She knew how to hold a conversation. I really can't believe I'm up here right now having to talk about her in the past tense, but God makes no mistakes. He had me with my aunt throughout these hard times to give me an opportunity to tell my aunt I love her over and over again. Remind her so she can know I was grateful for her love and it was felt. Now as for my cousin KK, that same togetherness that I spoke about earlier needs to remain intact. Because we're all grieving, but she needs us. We need each other as a family.
Let's give them another round of applause. Amen, amen. It's not easy to get up here and say anything, especially under these conditions. And so we praise God for their strength. Amen. The acknowledgments and condolences will be read by Sister Estelia Underwood at this time.
Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Because of the numerous cards received, I request of the family that no cards will be read at this time. However, they will acknowledge at a later date. But I will read for you two expressions of sympathy. An expression of sympathy in memory of Denise Holliday. To KK and the entire Holliday family. On behalf of Sharon Underwood Pope and family, please accept our condolences and the passing of your mother. May God embrace you and comfort during this difficult time. As you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, find comfort in the sweet memories of your mother. Know that God has loaned her to you for many years and now afforded her a home and a home. With heartfelt condolences, Sharon Underwood Pope and family. An expression of sympathy in memory of Denise Holliday. To KK and the entire Holliday family. On behalf of the Wayside Baptist Church Trustee Ministry, it is with deep sympathy that we send you these words to express to you and your family our sincere sympathy in the passing of your mother. May you be comforted by the outpouring of love surrounding you. Look back on all the good memories each of you shared and let it be a source of comfort. Deepest sympathy, Sharon Underwood Pope, Chairperson or Trustee, Reverend M. City Kumafia.
Amen. Let's give another round of applause. We're going to have the reading of the obituary by Marvis Holliday, Jarvis Holliday, Ashton Richardson, and company will come at this time, following which we'll have a praise dance by the praise team.
Good evening. I'm Jarvis Holliday, Denise Holliday's nephew. Denise Holliday, affectionately we called her Ma, Mommy, Grandma, Auntie, Niecy, Aunt Niecy to me and many of us, Cow Bunny, and Miss Daisy. She was born December 25th, 1959, in Brooklyn, New York, to the proud and loving parents of the late Barbara Holliday and Thomas Holliday. She was one of 10 children, Jimmy Holliday, Tommy Holliday, Paulette Henderson Holliday, Tracy Holliday, Craig, Peggy Holliday, Carlos, Edward McKeith Holliday, Bernadette Holliday, Thomasina Holliday, and Betty Holliday, who all preceded her in death. Denise quickly stepped in when her mother, Nunu, passed away in July 2021 to make sure that family traditions remained in place. Denise was born into a family that strongly believed in the core of family values. At an early age,
Denise took pride in taking care of her siblings. She was taught to love family, and because of that, her love for her entire family was endless. Her brightest smiles and highest honors came from being there for family, for her family. Her willingness to help others was unmatched. She took care of everyone and anyone that needed her. That was her niche. You can call on Niecy. She received her education and graduated from the New York City public school system. Though I would like to add an addendum that she did spend one school year in South Carolina. And if you were born and raised in Brooklyn like Aunt Niecy was, you would understand why she couldn't stick it out more than 1 year in South Carolina. At an early age, Denise accepted Christ in her life at Holy Sacrifice Baptist Church. She later recommitted her life to Christ. Denise was a driven professional and was no stranger to hard work. She had a love for numbers, which led her to a career at Chase Bank for over 20 years, retiring as a supervisor. Her years passed her by at Chase. She would also dedicate herself to promoting events where she helped NYC party promoters, including the Voice of Brooklyn, oversee the currency inside their venues. Denise's most rewarding job was being a mother. Anyone that knew her, when she took pride in raising her only daughter, Kenyatta, Kate, to be as hardworking with a heart of gold, just as she had been. She often referred to Kay as a twin, mini me, or Brad. People knew this through her many social media posts. She made the world aware of her love for her only child daily. Kay in return did the same for her. They were inseparable. Kay always gave her mother her flowers while she could smell them. And in return, Denise loved her daughter when unmatched. 16 years ago, Denise's love was upgraded to grandma. Kay brought her to this world. Denise's only grandson, CJ. Her love for her daughter and grandson was like no other. She made sure she was present for every occasion as a mother, grandmother, on 24/7 duty. Denise spent a lot of time helping others. Whether it was a listening ear, prayer, or much needed favor, she would make it happen. Her love for family and friends was endless. You could always see her out at events, smiling and dancing, enjoying life. She enjoyed creating photo collages for her loved ones, for their birthdays and holidays, and heartfelt messages on and off social media. That's definitely something I'm going to miss. Living in the South and not seeing her as often. She was very rarely miss your birthday, so get that post. That video and those photo collages, my aunt always went out of her way for that. That's one of the main things I'm going to miss about her. Being a Christmas baby, her love for people only enhanced her favorite holiday. Every year for the holidays, her home was filled with love and lots of decorations. Each year, the light show became a bigger and beautiful eyesore for the neighborhood to enjoy.
On July 20th, 2023, God said, "Well done, Denise," and decided her time on this earth had expired. God knew Denise fought a good battle and called his child home to rest. Denise is now at peace with our Lord. Denise's life will forever be cherished in the hearts of her loving and devoted daughter, Kenyatta, her loving and devoted life partner, Michael, her loving grandson, Chadwick Jr., her stepdad, Juan Dutelli, her nieces, Roxanne, Jamia, Rico, Katora, Tiffany, Dominique, Jacoby, Diana, Bria, Jada, Zatlin, Tonya, Kim, Katrina, and Denise, her nephews, Marvis, Covina, Jarvis, Andrea, Tyler, Alton, myself, Ashton, Jaquan, Jalen, Elijah, and Dennis. Her godchildren, Chanel, Taravia, and Danielle. Her best friends, Detroit, Jeannie, Mona, and DJ Scan. A host of aunts, uncles, cousins, other relatives, and friends. Denise was the epitome. Yes, she was. Epitome of a loving and caring person. She will greatly be missed. Denise will forever remain in our hearts and prayers. She will continue to live with her family and friends with the love and care and willingly share. We will love and cherish you forever, Macy.
Take me to the King.
My heart's torn in pieces. don't have much to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my
Special remarks coming from Bishop Gerald C. Brooks. Amen. And following which, after he speaks, he's not here, but they're plugging him up on the phone. Amen. After he speaks, then we're going to ask that the Rehoboth Cathedral Choir will sing another selection. And the next voice you will hear will be that of Pastor Gary McClellan Jr., and he's going to come to encourage the family with the word of the Lord. Amen.
To the Honorable Pastor, my friend, we love you. To the homilists, Dr. McClellan, and speak to the entire holiday family, Kiki, Pinky, Tracy, and my spiritual son, Tommy. I need to say you have picked up and sympathy from the Seabrook family, particularly from all the Rehoboth. Your darling niece was not a best friend, but I consider her. She was loving, hospitable, and kind, and I've grown to respect. She loved her family, but had a special love for her young Tommy. And we say to the entire family that the Lord will sustain you in this hour. I leave you with these words in Psalms 30. The scripture declares that the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open to their cry. So while your hearts are heavy and sorrowful, if you just cry out to the omnipotent one, the one who declares he's he will fulfill and sustain you in this hour of thought. I say to you that there is no that heaven cannot be. I end by saying we love you, but the Lord is not and ready to step in, give you the trick that only he can. May God sustain you, bless you, in Jesus' name.
The tears may fade away. Oh, Tonight. I said the devil is a liar. I know we're at a home going, but God is still good at a home going. I said God is still good at a hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Look at somebody and tell them, excuse me. You just don't know. You have no idea what I've been through. Hallelujah. Good. He's been good. He's been good. Just say tonight, the Lord's been good. The Lord's been good. The Lord's been good to the Lord's been good to our church.
Thank God for the privilege that He has afforded me to share with the family this evening. I am here to represent my father, my bishop, Bishop Gerald Seabrooks, who would be here if he was not out of the country. That's why he wanted to make it his business to share with you his love and the support of the Rehoboth family. Tommy Holiday is a faithful member of our ministry.
Yeah.
So whenever this family calls us or needs us, not just for Tommy, for all of you, we are here for you. So thank God for the musicians and the singers who are here to represent the Rehoboth family, as well as the ushers and everyone here from Rehoboth. Thank you so very much for being here to support this family. I can most definitely say that I understand what you're feeling. I have been here. Most of us have been here. And death is a very challenging event. It's something that precedes and after this day, we have to live with for the rest of our lives. When this is all over, reality hits and we have to now adjust our lives to the absence of the one that we love. Death is not easy. Death is very challenging. But I want to share with you, and I stand as a testimony on this evening, that with the help of God, you will get through this. I don't say that because I'm the preacher and I'm supposed to say that. I say that because I was in church, my phone was being blown up to tell me that my 35-year-old brother, who was in church, passed out in church and was unresponsive. Just to get there to see the fire department working on him and working on him and working on him, and then going to the hospital. And as I stood at the front desk, I saw, I never will forget this man's face. It was a short Jewish doctor who I saw out of the corner of my eyes. And when I saw him walking to me, I knew what he was going to tell me. And that my brother, who had no medical history whatsoever, in church praising God, is now gone. It's not easy. But I'm standing here to let you know that God will see you through this. So that's why it's gonna sound a little crazy, but I love to speak at funerals because I know what it is to be you. And I know what it is that you need in this moment. So if you would allow me the opportunity very briefly, as I prayed and asked God what to share with you today, he gave me one verse that's found in a conversation between Jesus and his disciples at a time that they were experiencing the same feelings that you are currently experiencing. If you don't have your Bibles, don't worry about it. By the time you find it, I'll probably be done. But St. John's chapter number 14, verse number 27, shares with us these words. This is Jesus talking to his disciples. He says, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled." Verse number one says, you believe in God, you believe also in me. But this verse says, neither let it, not you, don't let your heart be afraid. And from that verse, I want to talk to you for a few moments from this subject, the peace of God. You need the peace of God. Our text is found in the book known as the Gospel according to John. John, who authored this book, was a disciple, a student, a learner of Jesus Christ himself, which means what we read in his gospel is not something that he heard about. He shares with us what he himself heard and what he himself saw. And now he wants to share that message and what he experienced walking with Jesus for 3.5 years with the world. John is very intentional with what he chooses to share in his gospel. A matter of fact, in John chapter number 20, verses 30 and 31, John says these words. He says, many other signs truly did Jesus in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. He says, but these things were written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and by believing you may have life in his name. John makes clear that he was particular about what he would share with us in his book, because the goal of his book was to persuade us, after we finished reading it, that Jesus was more than a man. He convinced us that Jesus was not simply what some call the man upstairs, but Jesus was God himself. John, like a lawyer, wants to present his case to the world that Jesus was the Son of God, which equates, when you understand the Greek language, that he was God himself. So John shares things like this. He says, in the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. And the same was in the beginning. He said, in him, which means that the Word of God is a person. In him was life. And his life was light to all men. He shares with us that the light shined in darkness, but darkness could not comprehend it. The Bible tells us, John tells us, that he was in this world and the world was made by him. However, the very world he made rejected him. The Bible says, John says, he came unto his own, and his very own received him not. But those of them that did receive him, he gave power to become the sons of God. Then John goes as far as to say, and the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, a glory that we've never seen before, a glory that could only come from God. Jesus was full of grace and truth. John is clear about his assignment. Y'all can hear me? I got a big mouth, I can yell, but I need to. John was clear about his assignment. I want to persuade you that Jesus is God himself. He says, I want you to know something about him. What do you want me to know? He says, I want you to know, as Elder Clay just sang about, that God loves you. What do you mean God loves me? You know what I do. You know who I am. You know my life. Can I tell you that God does not care? Can I tell you that the Bible says that God not only loves you, he so loved you that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him would not perish but have everlasting life. John is clear on his assignment. But in our text, after John goes through a litany of things concerning who Jesus is, to establish who Jesus is, John invites us to a conversation between Jesus and his disciples. In chapter number 14, John shares with his disciples that he is about to leave. These men that have been walking with Jesus for 3.5 years are now beginning to hear from him that I am leaving. The Bible helps us to understand that this devastated them. This of being troubled and confused and hurt and worried, because now they have to figure out how will life be without Jesus. The last 3.5 years, all I've known was Jesus. For the last 3.5 years, I've left all to follow him, and now I have to adjust my life to live without him. Those of us who have ever experienced loss are trying to figure out what's going to happen next. What will I do now that he's gone? What will I do when he leaves? Jesus, knowing what was going on in their hearts, he says to them, though I am leaving, I'm leaving you with something. Though I am depart, I'm leaving you with something. Let me help the family today. And that's this. Though she's no longer here, she left you with something. This place ain't packed like this for someone who don't leave legacy.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
She left you with something. And here's a very encouraging thing that I've learned, and that's this. Don't relive her death. Celebrate her memory.
Come on. Come on.
Most people could never move on because they're stuck here. But there's more to her than this. Live in the memories. Will you cry? Yes. Will it hurt? Yes, but remember what she left behind. So as I conclude, I think I'm doing good with time. Jesus says, listen, I'm leaving. I know that you're troubled, but I'm leaving you with something. What am I leaving you with? He says, I'm leaving you with not just peace, my peace.
Jesus makes a distinction between the peace that he offers and the peace that this world offers. They are not one in the same. The world offers peace that requires everything to be okay for you to be okay. The peace that God offers does not require for everything to be okay for me to be okay. The peace that God offers is, even if everything in my life is chaotic, as long as God got me, I'm good. The peace that you need is not a peace that if this wouldn't happen, I'll be okay. Let me tell you something. Death is inevitable. Matter of fact, the Bible says funerals should remind us that we all go this way. Unfortunately, whether you love God or hate him, whether you believe in him or not, everyone is going to die. So I would not sell you a bill of goods to make you think that if you get into a relationship with Jesus, this is never going to happen to you. That's not true, and I'll be lying. But what the scripture teaches is that though we may go through similar situations, the difference between the believer and unbeliever is that God is presently and actively at work, working everything for our good. So today, my assignment is simple. What you need today is peace. You need peace, again, that does not say in order for me to have peace, everything has to be peaceful. I hate to be a bearer of bad news, but this world is about to get much worse than what it is. So if you're waiting for everything to be okay, for you to be okay, you ain't gonna never be okay. What you need, again, is an understanding that regardless of whatever happens around me and even to me, all is well with me. So today, God told me to share with this family that he understands your pain. He understands what it is that you are experiencing. He understands what it is that you are going through. But he also wants you to know that there is a peace that he offers that nothing or no one can take from you. The Bible describes it as peace that passeth all understanding. It literally means it is a peace that you don't even understand. You will ask yourself, why am I not crying? Why am I not in the pain that I used to be in? Is something wrong? No, nothing's wrong. Something's right. God has brought peace to your spirit. And as my brother put, here's the thing about the peace of God. You can't have the peace of God without God. God is a comforter. I'm telling you, he is. He literally is. But God, like every other gift that he offers, must be received. So today I want to pray for you that God will not just release his peace, but the greatest peace is not just a peace of God, it's peace with God.
Because we don't want to have a relationship with God where we want all his stuff but don't want him. And again, I try very hard to talk to people when I spend at all, but especially standing behind here. I can talk about peace all day, but I want to share with you that the peace that God gives comes along with God. So today, I want to pray that God would touch your hearts, that if you're not in a relationship with him, that you will seek one so that you can have the peace that comes only from him. If we think about it honestly, most of the things that the world offers us in the name of peace is self-destructive. Most of the things that we use to escape pain and hurt and difficulty and challenges usually hurts us in the long run. I want y'all to know that God peace don't hurt. There's no side effects to God's peace. He gives you a calmness in your spirit that says, I'm in pain, but I'm okay. I'm hurting, but we're going to be okay. Let's pray. Father, thank you so very much for the privilege that you have afforded me to share a simple message with this family and those who have been affected by this loss. That though this cannot be reversed, there is peace to deal with this. And tonight I pray that we not just seek peace from God, but we seek the God of peace. So if there's anyone here that does not know you as their Lord and Savior, I pray that your spirit will put a seek in them, because no man can know that you are Lord unless by your spirit. So tonight I pray that your spirit will so touch our hearts that we will seek you above everything and experience the peace that comes only from you. Continue to comfort them. Continue to strengthen them. Keep them even beyond today, when reality continues to set in and they have to adjust their lives, wondering what will happen next, like the disciples did with you. But the peace that you left them made things all good, even when they couldn't see how it would turn out good. So, Father, I pray that they will experience you and your peace, so that they will have a testimony that you are the God of peace. Thank you, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord another praise. Hallelujah. Amen, amen. As our director is coming, we just want to state that we'll do the committal here, and then the casket will be exited out of the sanctuary, and you can take it from there.
I'd like to thank Pastor McLennan and all our clergy members for the service also. On behalf of the family, I'd like to thank everyone who came here and gave them love and support during this time. And to the family, on behalf of the Lisa S. Doja Funeral Services, we want to thank you for giving us the opportunity to care for your loved one. As Pastor stated, after the committal, we will gather in the foyer area where we will have our final viewing. Tomorrow at 12 p.m., you're going with us to the Everett Green Cemetery for Sister Holliday's interment, please meet us at 75 Gapton Street. We will have our horse and carriage to the cemetery. Thank you.
Will the friends of the family please rise at this time for the committal portion of the service, following which we'll have the benediction by Pastor Greg Gary. All the friends of the family, please rise.
The other hearts and the ones in the back, we'll take them off the stands, and if you're able to put them in your car and help us bring them to the cemetery tomorrow, we would really appreciate it. Thank you.
Amen. As much as has pleased the Almighty God to take out of this world the soul of our deceased sister, we therefore now commit our body to the ground, earth to earth, ash to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the time to come. I heard a voice from heaven saying, "Blessed are the dead that die in the Lord, for their labor is not in vain in the Lord." Pastor's going to come with the benediction. It does.
Let's pray. Father, thank you so very much for this time to celebrate the memory of our sister Lucy Holliday. Please strengthen the family and all the people that have lost. Help them to live in the memory. Give them peace.
Lost.
but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first
blind, but